This tutorial is on designing geodatabases for storing spatial and non-spatial data in ArcGIS. Similar to shapefiles or rasters or tables or any other spatial or non-spatial data in ArcGIS, a geodatabase is sort of like a repository for all of your files, and it can allow you to streamline the editing process across multiple users, allow greater customization when you're creating shapefiles, and a whole host of other reasons. So to begin, similar if you're creating a shapefile, you need to right-click in your catalog. Go to New, you'll see a bunch of options for things to create. At the top is a file geodatabase. Very basic, just give it a name. Right-clicking that, and get some options around it. Copy it, you can delete it. Make it your default geodatabase. Any of those instances in which you've noticed you saved something and you don't know where it went, it usually goes to your default geodatabase, which is something that's stored in a completely different folder automatically when you install ArcGIS. So if you'd rather get greater control over where your outputs are going, you can save it here. Administration can allow you to compact and compress it. A distributed geodatabase is a way for editing or sharing shapefiles over a network. And finally, these new and import right here is how you actually get spatial and non-spatial data into a geodatabase. And so you can put a feature class, which is what we would look at as a shapefile. So it's a vector feature. You could also store tables, so non-spatial data here. You can store raster data sets. You can store tools, address locators. And then these interesting things called relationship classes and feature data set. So a feature data set is just if you want to have multiple feature classes grouped simultaneously. So let's say you have a lot of different layers that impact your road network. You have roads, maybe you have bike lanes, you have locations of bus stops or any other thing that could be used in a transportation service. You might put it in a feature data set so that you can join them. And a relationship class essentially is just what defines the relationship between things that are within a feature data set. So do they intersect? Do they overlap? When should they be used together, etc.? Very simply, right now, we're just going to create a feature class. So clicking on it, we'll go through a few pages to set it up. Give it the name, call it test class. Similarly, the alias does not need the underscore. What are we storing here? I'm going to create a line first. Needs to set it a coordinate system. Usually this is the one we work with, Pennsylvania South. XY tolerance, again, that's just at what level do two coordinate points, whether or not they overlap, should be seen as the same coordinate point. Don't worry about this. And then finally, sort of a much easier way to set up shapes, or rather to set up fields. I read shape there. So we're going to create one that's called year. I'm going to make it a text, even though it seems like that should be number, and we're going to come back to in a second why I made that. And there we go, test class. So right click again, we're going to make another one called test class 2. This time we're going to make it a polygon, and everything else is going to be the same. Pennsylvania, same XY tolerance, same thing, create a text year field. So notice in contrast to the shape files, they come up as blue. Otherwise, when you interact with them, they appear the same. Although they naturally have these two fields, shape area and shape length, where shape files do not. Those you'd have to calculate automatically. And they will calculate them in the units of whatever coordinate system they're projected in. And so we just saw me a second ago project these in the Pennsylvania State Plane coordinate system, which is using the unit feet. And so these will calculate their area in feet.